Well, new at 6 tonight, Governor Jerry Brown is not backing down.
That's right. Today he told KCRA3 that he is pushing forward with his proposal to put tax increases on the November ballot.
Taxes on a good day are extremely difficult. So it may not be, but, you know, I think we can get it done.
Although a recent poll shows support for the idea is slipping, KCRA3's David Beanick shows us what Governor Brown plans to do to try to reverse the slide.
At this meeting of police chiefs in Sacramento today, Governor Brown tried to enlist California's top cops to fight for his tax plan.
I hope you can join with me in the great debate between now and next November.
Brown's plan would raise income taxes for people making more than $250,000 a year, and it would raise the state sales tax for everyone by half a cent.
Taxes on a good day are extremely difficult.
In fact, after polls earlier this year showed 72% and 58% support for the governor's tax plan, the most recent Public Policy Institute of California poll showed support has dipped to just 52%. Republicans say, "We told you so."
As more and more people become aware of the facts, personally, I believe that's why there is less support.
The governor's plan also faces competition from the left, from two competing tax increase initiatives. He said today he's still trying to get supporters of those initiatives to drop out, but acknowledged that's not likely.
I'm not going to try to, therapy sessions for those who have a different perspective.
Does the Brown administration need to come up with a plan B at this point?
No, we just need to get behind the governor and help him to be successful in this.
Now, the governor told the police chiefs today that his supporters are very close to getting the 800,000 signatures needed to put his tax plan on the ballot in November. He told us he plans to submit those signatures sometime in early May, so about 2 months from now.
About 2 months from now. So, David, what happens if his tax plan actually fails?
Well, the governor has said again and again that he does plan to balance the state books one way or the other. His plan includes eliminating the $9 billion budget deficit with half taxes and half cuts. He says if this initiative fails, it'll be all cuts.
On top of already some painful cuts that have already been made. David, right. Thank you.